Morning in the kitchen, Chef Cesin Curi is here from Los Andes restaurant, and we're making Silpancho. I hope I'm pronouncing that. It's a Bolivian steak recipe.
Correct.
So for the viewers at home, before we go through the ingredients, just tell us what that means, a Bolivian steak recipe.
Well, I mean, Silpancho is something, it's a very typical dish from South America, especially from Bolivia. That's where it originated from.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a steak that, it's more like a, they seem like a veal parmesan.
Mm.
But the difference between it is that we actually encrust the breadcrumbs directly into the steak. So as you can see with this piece of meat right here, it's about 12 ounces. We're gonna give it a triple butterfly on each side, then encrust it with the panko. We're gonna saute some white rice, then steam it off.
Okay, we're going back to the steak for a second, mm-hmm. just as nobody knows what that means, to butterfly it.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna open it up,
mm-hmm.
Making the steak all even.
Mm-hmm.
So this way, and it'll be about a centimeter in width.
I like that because it'll be nice and thin.
It'll be thin, it'll be tender, it'll be crispy, it'll be amazing. And especially when we finish it off with the salsa. The salsa is what makes this dish, is the tomatoes, the red onions, and the jalapenos, all finely diced. And then we finish it off with fried eggs. So this is a recipe, I mean,
interesting.
That my mother's been making for me since I was a little boy in Bolivia. I come home from school, and I could just smell it as I'm walking home to the house. And once again, it's actually one of my favorites, believe it or not.
Well, we know if we're gonna have this recipe, then we should have it from you for sure. And you were saying that it reminds you of veal. What was it again?
Like a veal parmesan.
Okay. So for somebody who doesn't eat veal, me included, this
correct.
Is a great option.
Definitely.
Well, good.
Is.
All right. I know you guys are gonna be cooking in the next segment, so thanks so much, Cesin.
No worries.
And we'll send it back to you guys.
It's going great. I've been told to don some gloves. So here I am with Chef Cesin in the Rhode Show kitchen. Los Andes is the place. And what's on the menu?
All right, we're going to be making a silpancho. So what we're going to do is we're going to get this. This is actually a flap sirloin. What we're going to do is we're going to give it a little bit of butterfly cut. And then you're going to be having some fun with that panko. So
okay.
What we want to do is cut the steak right down to the center.
Mm-hmm. So you're not going all the way through, just
exactly.
kind of thinning it out there?
Pretty much, exactly. You want to be able just to make it as thin as possible, and it's also the same width.
And I know people use this technique for other meats as well, right? You might see other types of meats being butterflied.
Correct, definitely. I mean, even if you go to the restaurant and you want to get a steak well done, which you shouldn't, but when they do, just to make the cooking process a little bit even and more faster.
Okay.
All right, so what we did, now once we have our steak butterfly, we want to do is you want to just slightly pound it out.
Tenderizing it.
Correct. Now we're gonna do is we're gonna season it.
Why is that important to tenderize the meat?
Well, what it does, it breaks down the muscle, the meat just a little bit, and making it more tender. Now what you're gonna do is encrust the panko directly into the meat. A lot of recipes, a lot of people might be used to using like a flour and egg base.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna put a little bit of the panko right on top for you.
These are thick.
Correct.
Pieces,
this is like a Japanese breadcrumb.
Okay.
So what you wanna do is hit the in an angle. Directly encrusting.
So I'm really like pushing
correct.
That in there.
1 second. There's no use of flour or egg or anything along those lines. So what you want to do is directly put the breadcrumbs directly into that steak, making it as thin as possible. And what we're going to do is we're going to give it a flash fry in the next segment.
Okay.
And you'll see how simple it is. Don't be afraid. Believe me. Just take your frustration out.
I'm not. Oh, here we go.
Definitely. There you go. So this is, once again, it's a very typical dish in South America. It's usually served, for lunch or for dinner, topped off with a great salsa that usually consists of tomatoes and onions. And I did bring some spicy peppers.
Yeah!
They're locked away in the refrigerator.
Bring it back! I'm going to try something else spicy. Every time, if you haven't seen it, Chef Cesin always brings something spicy, and I always got to try it, whether I'm going to burn my tongue off or not. I'm trying it today.
All right, definitely. I have some good peppers for you today.
Okay, sounds good. That's coming up a little later in the show. Back to you.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Cesin is here from Los Andes. We're making Silpancho.
Silpancho.
Silpancho, which is Bolivian steak. And it smells
correct.
Great. That's why we got
so
the fan
good.
On, too.
Yeah, we got the fan on.
Yeah,
we got a little
fan.
Heat
cooking.
Going on over the stove.
All right, so what we're
going
to do is we're going to get this pan going here.
All right. Mm-hmm.
The first thing that we're going to do is, well, you're going to take care of the eggs.
Okay.
All right?
Got it.
And we're gonna start cooking this steak.
Got it.
So you need the eggs?
I need the eggs.
Yes,
there you
sir.
Go.
Glad you didn't throw them at me.
All right. So here's the tricky part with this steak is it has to cook very fast. You can go ahead and drop them right in there, brother.
Just grab these suckers?
Yes, sir. Right onto the pan. It's a little bit of oil there. Now we're gonna do is we're gonna drop the silpancho.
Okay. That's
wanna
me?
Yes, ma'am.
And it's fun to say silpancho.
Silpancho.
Now, what's happening here? Because this is a large piece, and
right,
I don't know if it'll all fit in that pan.
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to show you the trick here.
Okay.
All right, so this is the steak that we made in the previous segment.
Yes.
As you can see, it's grown just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do is you want to put it right in the center.
Okay.
And as this meat cooks, it's fairly thin, so it will start shrinking in size.
Interesting. So it's okay if it's kind of leaning on the edges there.
Correct. And I'll start going down as it goes.
Okay.
So we have our eggs going, we have the steak going. Right behind here, we have a plate of rice, which I'm gonna place right in front of here for
you. What kind of rice would you use for a dish like this?
This is a long grain rice. What we do is we saute with a little bit of onions and tomatoes, give it a little bit of a kick. Okay. What we're gonna do is get a roasted potatoes, which are gonna be right in that bowl right there.
Okay. I knew it. It smelled like French fries in here.
So that's good. All right. So Silpancho, this is the way it's done. You usually just put the potatoes right on top. Okay.
You said this is a very popular dish. Is that right?
Correct. In South America, Silpancho, everybody knows the Silpancho. As you can see, the steak is starting to get a nice little bit of a color.
And again, it cooks fast because we've pounded it down.
We did pound it very thinly, and. The way that we're gonna serve is you wanna cover the entire dish with the steak, finishing it with the eggs, topping it off with the salsa.
And it's like a blanket of meat, Will.
It pretty much is. It's pretty much like a blanket of
Will's
meat.
Will's dreams have come true, a blanket of meat.
I'm a simple man. The clouds have parted and they brought meat.
All right, so a couple things that we're gonna be doing too at the restaurant that's coming up soon is we're trying to get the second floor going, which is the most exciting thing. This is kind of a dream coming true for our family. The second floor of the restaurant is gonna be called the Aymara Bar. Aymara Bar. So upstairs we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be making a ceviche bar.
Okay.
Yum. We made ceviche here before.
Definitely. So what we're gonna be doing upstairs is showcasing different types of ceviche. And once again, one of the things that we're trying to do with the ceviche is kind of make it almost like the new trend. You know, like sushi took off really far off with the sushi bars and whatnot. We're gonna try to duplicate the same thing, but using our style of ceviche, which would be great.
That is great.
This is really cooking pretty fast, too.
It is.
This meat, you got the eggs in here.
I'm not going to lie. It took just a little longer than I expected. I'm not going to lie. At the restaurant, usually it just takes a couple of seconds. But, all right. So, we're almost done here. Should be just a couple more minutes.
The eggs, too, we're keeping sunny set up.
Definitely.
Yes? Okay.
We're going to keep them right sunny and try to put them right on top if we get to finish the steak here. Should be just a couple more minutes.
Okay. I'm getting that pan nice and
tell everybody
hot
again
over
what
there.
You have on it. The crumbs that are on top here.
These are actually panko. It's a Japanese breadcrumb. It's just a little bit thicker than your normal breadcrumbs. Mm-hmm. It usually allows to give you a little more texture onto the meat.
Beautiful.
Looks good. It has great
now,
smell.
Now, I also heard
flavor.
That you have something spicy in here for me.
All right.
Well, here we go.
All right.
Here we go.
It's the fridge.
This is just a whole jalapeno season.
So I just bite into it?
I mean, if you really want to get the spice kick, please help yourself. I mean, it should be okay.
Tastes like a green pepper.
It does. Well, once you get to the seeds, it's going to give
it
a little bit of kick
you.
Of the spice.
Okay. All right. Good.
I think I'm doing okay for now.
So far, so good.
All right.
We are going to put this all together. It smells great here in the Rhode Show kitchen. Think it hit. We're going to put it all together. And if you want this recipe, you can head to our website, WPRI.com.